Hello, welcome to Cornwall. My name's Andy Paramore, and today we're going to be making a small lidded box in the shape of a button, putting little knickknacks and pins or whatever in. So let's go and make it. Right, first of all, making myself a glue block. This is 3 inches, 75 mil that way, 4 inches, 100 mil that way. Fix onto the back of it is the faceplate with 4 screws. Do not use plasterboard screws or drywall screws, as they are way too brittle to hold something like this. They'll just snap off, so make sure you use decent quality screws to hold it on. And we're just going to true it up so it's nice and round, and also true up the face. Bring up the tailstock, tighten him off. Chisel. There we go. Spindle gouge. Make sure that it runs and everything's solid. We're in at 1700 RPMs. Run the chisel on the top. If there's a little bobble, it tells us that it's not quite round. Should be okay. There we go, nothing fancy. Take away the tailstock. Bring that round. I'll use a round and a scraper just to level the face off. If anything, we'll probably make it slightly concave rather than if it was convex, it would only be holding in the centre, whereas if it's slightly concave, it holds all around the edge nicely. Flat. That'll be fine. It's a bit fluffy, so I'll just run a bit of sandpaper on it. I'm just in the process of getting some kind of dust extraction system going. But I haven't got it set up yet, so I've got a fan blowing it. Has that away out of my face. That's fine. Okay. This is one I want to copy, more or less, but in a piece of ash. It's a little bit bigger. So what I've done is this outer circle, which is the finished diameter, I've made as big as possible on the two pieces of ash that I've got. One's going to be the top, the lid, and one the base. It's only going to be shallow, but that's what I've got. So made the outer circle as big as possible. The next circle in is 10 mil, just under half an inch in from that, and you can make that whatever you want. It's just what looks right to me. And then I've got four holes, so by finding the center with the cross, all I need to do is do a circle in the middle between the center point and that line, approximately. So I'll find that, draw a circle, and where it crosses those four points is the center of each one of those holes. So now I need to go and drill a whatever it is, probably 15 mil hole in each one of these, just on the lid, that is. So I'll go off and drill those four holes. You don't need to see that. That's got the four 15 mil holes drilled with a Forstner bit. Now I'll take it over to the bandsaw and just take the corners off, make it a bit easier to turn, and save a bit of trouble. I'll do that on both top and bottom. That's got them both round on the bandsaw. What I haven't mentioned is when I got my original center point, I used one of these. It's a spring-loaded punch, and I used it to listen. That's a little spring, and it punches a hole in the center. Now, that's a good reference point to keep as well, because when I glue this onto there, I will to keep, because if I just glue it on, I might be able to get it roughly in the right place. But if I bring the tailstock up and bring the tails, see if I can get you a better view. There we go, that's better. Yeah, I can roughly get it in the right place, but with that punched hole in there, if I bring the tailstock up, get the glue already on the back, put it in place, then I can bring the tailstock up, put it into that, press it against the glue block. It holds it in place until the glue hardens, and it's guaranteed to be in exactly the right spot for turning. So I'll get the hot glue gun going. Okay, the glue gun's heated up. We'll put a ring of glue around here. You've got to work pretty fast before the glue starts to set. Helps if you don't run out. Pop it on there and bring up the tailstock. Press it on. There's a bit of extra security. We'll run a bead of glue around the joint as well. Okay, we'll give that a couple of minutes to set. Okay, we'll turn it round and hollow out the lid. Okay, that's okay inside. I just want to try and finish the outside a bit better. better. Right, I'll sand up the inside and then get back to you. Okay, that's the inside of the lid polished up. To do the top of the lid, we'll mount it onto the base of the box and turn them smooth together, and then turn the top of the lid. So I'll just knock this off here, and I'll hot glue the base onto there to turn the base. I'll put the plate into the vise to knock it off, because I don't want to knock it off here and put strain on the spindle, so I'll do that off camera. Okay, we've got this the base mounted on the lathe exactly the same way as I did the lid. I've got the diameter of the lid, and I want to make sure that base doesn't go any narrower. I can afford for it to be a little bit bigger than this, and I can turn them both together, but if it's narrower, then I've got to return the lid, so I don't want to do that. So we'll just make this a little bit, the diameter a little bit greater than the lid, and then we'll flatten the face, which is going to be the bottom eventually, and we will put a little tenon on there so that my chuck fits into there, and I'll make the tenon just slightly wider than the chuck is in its closed position, and I'll put parallel sides on the tenon. Very close, touch mark. That's almost it, that'll do. Take the tailstock away. Got my calipers set to the size of the chuck. Thank you. just going to put a few little rings just as details on the bottom inside there. And, oh yes, I want to just flatten the base. Again, if anything, we want to make it a little bit concave so it's not rocking, it's nearly flat anyway. I'll give that a sand and then come back. Okay, we've turned a little tenon on the base and we'll fit it into the chuck. Onto the chuck. We'll true up the face first. And then put a little rebate and keep trying the lid on until it fits. Right, that's nice and tight. Bring the tailstock up and turn them both together. think we'll sand this before we take the tail stock away. Put a little bit of sanding sealer on it and leave it a minute to dry. I'll just give that a minute to dry. And we'll put some abrasive paste on. A bit more. Off the excess. Some homemade shine juice. Leather pad in case it gets hot. and a bit of wax polish. See what kind of fit that is now. It's held on pretty well. We'll finish turning the face. Made nice gentle cuts, I think. Oops, maybe not. Might put a bit of tape around that just to make sure it holds in place. Right. I think what I'll do, I'll put a little burnt line where the joint is to give it a bit of detail and sort of hide the joint. But I need to bring the tail stock just to stop that lid popping off. Just gently bring it up. After all that, I've forgotten to turn the inside. Right, we'll do that now. So there we are, a little lidded box in the shape of a button. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, hit the little notification bell, and please leave a comment. It's nice to see them. And until next time, Cornwall. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.